Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Remember to subscribe and press the notification button. Share my video, like my video, sit back, watch, and then leave a comment. Thank you. Today I'm going to do a book, analyze a book by Mariam Abaya, that is So Long and Later. I'm going to take you through this book today and just relax and enjoy the book. Okay, So Long and Later is a book written by Mariam Abaya. Is a very long letter that really shows us the meaning of the title, the outer meaning of the title, So Long a Letter. It's a letter written by Ramotulai about the experiences of her life, and she writes this letter focusing on everything that rotates around her life. It's probably like a diary to her, and she sends this letter to a friend, that is Alcee Tau. Okay, first, this book deals a lot with feminism. As we all know, it focuses a lot on the women character in the book. We see the likes of Ramatulai, we see the right of Alcee Tau, we see the likes of Binetu, we see the likes of Daba in the book, and we see a lot of characters that everything rotates around are the female in this book, and how they are mistreated in the society, how they are treated, and the most important thing is how they respond. They respond this differently, because women are really different, and this woman will suggest that, okay, because my husband is doing this to me, I will decide and respond this way. But another woman will see that this is negative, respond in the other way. And so this book really focuses a lot on the women and how they respond to whatever happens to them in the society. First of all, we see Ramatulai. The book begins with the sudden death of Mado, that's the husband of Ramatulai. And after the death, Ramatulai reflects on their lives immediately after they married, how everything used to go, how they loved each other, and all turned back, because after that the husband decided that I'm going to marry another woman and leave you. And after that, Ramatulai is left with 12 children, and raising them as the only parent, a single parent, was really a challenge to her. And there are a lot that happens to these children in the process of being raised with a single mother. So Ramatulai decides to write a letter to Alcee Tau, that is a longtime friend. And Alcee Tau, if we remember well, Alcee Tau is one who is divorced. Her husband was really into another woman, just because they claim that because Alcee Tau was a goldsmith daughter, they decided that, oh, I'm not going to marry someone who is not from a noble class. And because of this, Alcee Tau decides even to divorce the husband and focus on her education abroad, that is in America. And after that, we see that the husband, Maudo, decides to move on with the wife, that is Nabo, that was given to him with an aunt, that is Aunt Nabo, because of the class. She was from the same noble class as Maudo. So look at this woman. Immediately after realizing that this is what is happening, my husband decided to move on with another woman. That is, they are promoting polygamy. Because of my class, I'm deciding to go and work hard in my education so that someday I'll get someone better. And Alcee Tau decides to leave. And now Rama, who is a longtime friend, is left alone back in Senegal. Rama decides that, okay, if my husband decides to have another wife, then who am I to question? I'll just leave it at that point, because maybe I'm not attractive to him, maybe he's done with me, and now I'm going to decide to live alone, and remember, with 12 children. And the most challenging part, we see that Daba, that is the daughter to Ramatulai, comes back with the very best friend at home, that is Benetu. Binetu is a close friend to the daughter of Rama. They're friends in school, they study together, they come back home, and most of the time they seek advice from Ramatulai. And most of the time, Binetu could always talk about the sugar daddy. And this sugar daddy they didn't know. They didn't know who this sugar daddy really was. And most of the time, Ramatulai could advise Binetu on avoiding the sugar daddies. And at some point, Binetu came back and said that my parents are insisting that I should marry the sugar daddy because the sugar daddy is providing everything that we need in the family, buying me new clothes and everything that I need. And they're insisting on me marrying the sugar daddy. And Ramatulai advised Binetu that it's not right. Focus in your education first. And after that, one Sunday, we are introduced to a very colorful wedding where Binetu weds Mado. So you can imagine someone that you've been advising, you didn't know that it's ironical. It was so ironical because now you are advising this a small girl, a girl of 17 years old, and you are a woman here with 12 children. You have experience about life. You are the woman in the society who is respected because of the position of your husband. And now your husband bends too low to marry this kind of woman, a small baby, and you're even confused. Should I even beat this child? Should I just take a cane and beat this child and throw her out of my house? And now Rama decides to live with the child in the house and never to allow even jealousy to come across them. And now, because of immediately after marriage, they come together. That is Tamsa, that is the brother to Modo, and together with Maudo, that is the friend to the Maudo, the friend. They come back home and decide that, okay, you decided that you're going to accept this and you're going to live with it, and now your husband has decided to go back and live with Binetu. Then they live together. Rama is abandoned together with the children, and she has to raise money. She has to raise these children in a way that is presentable in the society. Sorry. And in the midst of raising these children, you find out that it's so challenging because you find there are three sons, they are called the trio. These three sons involve in a terrible accident. They are hit by a motorbike, and one of the children's leg is broken. And as a mother, you have to face this alone without the father to support you, to help you through it. And the light really dims on the side of Ramatulai, and she's really a strong woman, as it is evident. On the other hand, Daba decides to marry off just like that. On the other hand, the second daughter now is again pregnant, and you see that this daughter is pregnant. What can I do with my daughter? I didn't raise my daughter this way. And now the early pregnancy really shook Rama, and she never knew what to do because she thought that they lacked the paternal love. That's why all this happened to them. And then Rama decides that, okay, I'm going to invite the boyfriend back here at my home so that we can decide on how we are going to go about it. But together with Fatama, that is the friend of Ramatulai, they come back home. They decide to talk to the boyfriend, and the boyfriend accepts the responsibility, and they decide that even if the child is born, the mother to the boyfriend will live with the child so that the daughter of Ramatulai could continue with education. As a mother, it's really saddening because now two of your daughters have already messed up. Three of them are really a pain to you, and you can't even take it. And then on the other hand, some of two other girls involved in drug abuse, and you can see as a woman it's really hard to take all this as a single parent. And Rama decides that, okay, I'm going to understand them. I'm going to allow love to take the lead, love to lead me. They are my children, and there is nothing that I can do about it. And that really shows the challenges that Rama undergoes as a single mother. And then we again meet Rama being proposed to by Dauda Dienga. That was the ex-boyfriend who proposed to her, and she refused. And then she's coming back a second time after Rama has 12 children, and you can imagine how it's difficult to believe, because already this man is also married somewhere, and Rama also was married, and the husband is now dead. she can't take it and decide that, refuse the proposal. Even though the woman, the man looked classy, the man was so stable and all that, and had the pure love that Ramatulai lacked. But Ramatulai decides that, no, I'm not going to accept it, and decides that, no, I'm not taking it. On the other hand, Tamsil, that is the brother to the husband, Nodu, decides to come back to propose even to Ramatulai, because they believe that if your husband is dead, you must be inherited. And he decides that, I'm going to inherit this woman because I love him, because of everything and the personality and how she carries out herself. And in turn, Rama decides and says that, I have lived 30 years of silence, 30 years of misunderstandings under the custody of my husband. And because all along she's been silent, a lot is done and she never talk about them, she decides that it's time I speak, it's time I refuse and I say what needs to be said. And she decides that, I'm going to refuse all this and I'm going to live my own life. I don't want anything, I don't want anyone in my life. And Ramatulai decides again to refuse the proposal of Tamsil. And that's how we see the life of Ramatulai, how it really goes. And a lot of challenges are seen, because now as a woman, she needed love, she needed someone to come back to, someone to have her shoulder. But now again, what does the society expect? It expected that Ramatulai would settle for this one, this brother to the husband, because it's now their goal. And because of respect that Ramatulai even earned in the during the time the husband was still alive, really shows that as a woman, the society of Senegal depended on the title of the husband, so that a housewife can be respected, which Ramatulai decides, no, I'm not going to take it, it's enough, and I'm not going to work with it. On the other hand, the Muslim culture in this society decides that, okay, what we are going to do, because your husband has died, because we are introduced to the death of the husband, and the first page of the book, the introduction talks about the sudden death of the husband. And now they decide that, okay, what we're going to do, you're going to be inside your house for 40 days and nights without coming out, interacting with anyone. And you find during this period that she decides to write the long, long letter to Aissoutou. And during this period, the woman is expected to stay alone in the house, not to interact. And it's really hectic, because now the society expects you to be there. And it's during this time that she gets discouraged, because now a lot of stuff's happened in the society. They come back to her with inheritance issues, the children issues and all that. But Aissoutou decides that, I have decided this life, I'm going to live this life, whether you like it or not, this is what I'm going to do. And this actually what happens in the book. And even at the end of the book, Rama decides and says that, okay, Aissoutou, this is the last letter, the last long letter I'm writing you. To mean that is the end of all the complaints and all that and all the diary. She's going to begin a new life. Thank you so much. We'll stop at that point. Watch my video. Leave a comment below. And remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel. See you some other day. Thank you.